Good morning, children. So today we are going to start our next topic, and that is chapter number 12. The cock is crowing. What? The cock is crowing. Okay. So cock is a bird. Okay. And what cock is doing? The cock is making a loud cry. Okay. So a cock is crowing. So this picture, this scene, we just see in the morning, okay? So in the morning, we have heard many cocks, okay? Those who crow, okay? So let's start this poem. This is actually a poem, all right? So here, what we have to do, write about any five things you observe when you wake up in the morning. So whenever you wake up in the morning, what are the things you observe, okay? So you can write like sunrise, okay? Sun, you can see the sunrise in the morning, okay? When we wake up, we see that one thing, okay? And we can hear the chirping of the birds, okay? We can feel the freshness, okay? The air, the environment is very cool in the morning, okay? So these kinds of things we just see in the morning when we wake up, all right? So this you have to write here now. Let's start the poem. So this poem is very interesting and it is written by William. You have to learn the name of the poet also. Okay, William Wordsworth, who is actually a very famous poet. William Wordsworth. Okay, he is a very famous poet and he has written many poems and many prose. Okay. So let's start the poem. You can see in the picture the scene is very beautiful and whatever is given here in through the poem, everything is described very beautifully. All right. So before the starting of this poem, I just want to give a brief introduction of it. So this poem begins with the crowing of the cock indicating the beginning of the day. Okay. So we just see when the cock crows in the morning, so it is just indicating, it shows that the day has been started. Okay, it is the time to rise for everybody, for birds, for animal, for human being, for everyone. The day is started. So this is the starting of the day, right? So we can say that as with the crowing of the cock, that indicates the beginning of the day. And consequently, it symbolizes the starting of something new. So it also symbolizing here that this is the beginning of something new. All right. So here we will see the streams of the water flowing amidst the lands. Okay. So you can see amidst means in between. Okay. The stream is flowing in between the lands. Okay. And what it indicating? It is indicating the routine and continuity of the world. Okay, so world goes to be continue. Okay, so as we are watching this stream, which is actually flowing from this hill, from this mountain, okay, it is showing the continuity of our routine work of our life. Okay, all right. The poem tries to bring out the beauty of changing seasons. Okay, so through this poem, we will get to know that how beautifully the poet William Wordsworth has described the changes in the season. Okay, so this poem brings out actually the essence of the nature and trees and tries, sorry, and tries to draw parallels between human life as winter is being taken over by spring. Okay. So here what is given? The human life, which is actually parallel to the parallels with the human life is given. Okay, as winter is being taken over by spring. Winter goes and spring season comes. Okay, and the view that we are watching, the picture that we are watching, which is given in this poem, it is indicating the view. It is showing the view of spring season. So which season is given here? Spring season. After the winter, there is happiness all around and the nature is beautiful because now the spring season has been started. All right. Now let's start the poem now. So who is the poet? You should know the name of this poem is The Cock is Crowing. Okay. The Cock is Crowing. It is written by William spelling I have written wrongly. Okay, William William Wordsworth. Who is the poet? William Wordsworth. William William Wordsworth. 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 Okay. Now let's start it. So we will read this poem in three lines. Okay. So three lines will contain one stanza. So this is one stanza. All right. The cock is crowing. The stream is flowing. Okay. The cock is crowing. Cock is not at all given. Okay. We will. These are the birds. All right. And stream is flowing. The small birds are twitter. Okay, small birds twitter. So twitter means chirp, as they are making sound. Their sounds, their voice is called chirp. Okay, the lake doth glitter. So doth means does. Glitter means what? Glitter means sparkle or shine. Okay, shine. So again I will read. The cock is crowing, the stream is flowing, the small birds twitter, the lake doth glitter. Okay, the green field sleeps in the sun, the oldest and youngest are at work with the strongest. The cattle are grazing, their heads never raising, there are 40 feeding like one. Okay. So if we talk about the rhyming scheme, okay, it will be separated. We will count it separate and these six lines separate. Okay, the cock is crowing, we will put here A. The stream is flowing, this is B. The small birds twitter, okay, it is also A because it is going with crowing. Okay, crowing and flowing. So this is A. Twitter, this is B. Glitter, again B. Okay, so first four lines are having rhyming scheme A B B. All right, now let's talk about remaining six lines. So sun, I'll put here A. Youngest, this is different from A, so I will count it B. Strongest, it is same as youngest, so this is also B. Grazing, so this is not going with A or B, so it I'll put it C. Raising, so it is going with C, so this is C. Okay, like one, sun, one. Okay, A. So rhyming scheme in these six lines: A B B C C A. Okay, and in these four lines we will have here A A B B. Okay, A A B B. Okay, so again I will read this stanza. The cock is crowing, the stream is flowing, the small birds twitter, the lake doth glitter. The green field sleeps in the sun, the oldest and youngest are at work with strongest. The cattle are grazing, their heads never raising, there are 40 feeding like one. Okay, so this I have told. What is there? The green field sleeps in the sun. Okay, you can see the green field. It is looking like it is sleeping under the sun. The oldest and youngest. So everybody is working in the field. Okay, they are on their work. The cattle are grazing. Okay, the cattle are grazing here. Their heads never raising, and they were grazing only, and their heads are down. Okay, and they are 40 feeding like one. They are in a sequence, and they look like they all are one. Okay, their everyone's head is down and they are just grazing. Okay, now as the day begins, okay, with the sound of the cock. Okay, as cock is crowing, it means what? It is the sound of the cock, and it is indicating as the day has been started. The day begins with the sound of the cock, indicating the rise of the new day. Okay, it is the beginning, or we can say the rise of the new day. Okay, amidst the continuity of the stream flowing. Okay, the stream is flowing here. All right, the birds chirp around, right? The lake glitters and shines. Okay, as seen, as sun moves over green fields. Okay, People, young and old, regardless of their age, are seen to be working with, okay, you can see the people, okay, as the sun rises, everybody go to their work, okay, it doesn't matter, they are young or old, regardless of their age, okay, everybody concentrates, we can see the concentration, they concentrate on their work, okay, not raising their heads, while the cattle graze around like one entity, okay, they are like one entity, like one, they all were grazing, rather a group of 40. So it doesn't looking like that 40 are there, it is looking like entity, okay, like one entity, one group. So a normal day in the world is described in order to show routine. So it is, what is given here, the routine is given here, routine of the work, okay, that is given, that's set in, this is set here, okay, the routine work is set in this stanza. By stressing the different aspects of nature, we can see the sun is rising, the cattle are grazing, stream is flowing, birds are chirping. So this is what it shows, it indicates the routine work of the people, okay. So by stressing the different aspects of nature, what poet is doing here? Wordsworth draw a detailed picture in the reader's head, in our head, which added to the authenticity, okay, the truthfulness, that this point is actually true, of the emotions and feelings. So our emotions and feelings are described here in form of the aspects of the nature. All right, so this is stanza number one. If I we will talk about stanza number two. So what is given in stanza number two? Like an army defeated, the snow hath retreated, and now doth fare ill on the top of the bare hill. The ploughboy is whooping anon anon, there's joy of the mountains, there's life in the fountains, small clouds are sailing, blue sky prevailing, the rain is over and gone. So again, we will talk about the rhyming scheme. Defeated, I will put it A. Retreated, again the sound is as A. So this is also A. Ill, B, hill, B. So these four lines are having rhyming scheme. A, B, B. Okay. Now next, the ploughboy is whooping anon anon. Okay, so first of all, understand what is ploughboy. A ploughboy who leads the animal, okay, is ploughboy, okay, who leads animals, okay, is a ploughboy. Whooping anan means here what? It is actually showing the crying out, okay. So he is crying here, he is shouting, crying out, or we can say shouting. There's a joy in the mountain, there's life in the mountain. So anan, I will put here A, mountains. This is B, fountains. Again, the sound is going with mountains. So this is also B, okay. Sailing, it is not going with A or B. So I will put here C, prevailing. Yes, the sound is similar as sailing, okay. So rhyming is going with it, C. So gone, anan, gone. So it is going with A. Again, these six lines are having the rhyming scheme A, B, B, C, C, A. Okay, A, B, B, C, C, A. All right. So here A, B, B, and here A, B, B, C, C, A. Okay, got it. So this is the rhyming scheme here. Okay, now if I'll talk about this stanza. So here, like an army defeated, the snow hath retreated, hath retreated. So first we will understand the meaning here, okay. So hath means have, snow have retreated, retreated means gone back, okay. All right, fair here means cost, okay, the value, cost. All right, now so snow is here in this stanza. Snow is compared to a defeated army, army which has been lost in the battle, okay. So as it retreats or withdraws after being defeated, and the spring takes over the earth. Okay, so as snow, or we can say winter season, is defeated, okay, has been defeated, so who has taken the place? Spring season has taken the place of winter season. Okay, now without the snow, the hills, so hill is bare. So without snow, how is hill? Hill is bare. All right, and open to change. Now it is open to change as there is no snow. Okay, hill is bare, greenery is there, so it is open for a change. You can just plant a tree, you can crop anything there. All right, so it is ready to for the change. The bare hills will be covered in green. Okay, it will be covered in green as spring season is there, just after the winter season. So it will be covered in green and flowers in no time, because the spring season. Okay, as the springtime begins, a plowboy. So who is the plowboy? A boy who leads the animal. Okay, a plowboy who leads the animal is very happy. And why? As the springtime begins, so he is very happy and he goes around with joy. Okay, so this is given. A plowboy is whooping anan anan. It means what? He is being very happy here. Okay, and he is making a sound. The mountain and fountains seem to come to life. Okay, so this you can see here. There's a joy in the mountains. There's a life in the fountains. So what does it mean? The mountains and the fountains seem to come to life as spring takes over the harsh winter days. As a spring is there after the harsh winter day, so everybody has taken a breath. Okay, the skies. So now small clouds are sailing. What does it mean? The skies are blue and clear with small clouds moving very smoothly. Okay, small clouds are sailing. Okay, blue sky prevailing. So what is the meaning of prevailing? In existence. Okay, now blue sky, you can see the blue sky. Okay, just because the weather is very clear, so in existence. Now blue sky is there. Okay, the sky is clear. So the days of rain, winter and harsh times are over. Okay, so blue sky means now the days of rain, winter and harsh time, that has been gone. Okay, while the first stanza, so here we can see in the first stanza the day is normal, right? And the second stanza gradually shows the changing, okay, changing times with the changing seasons, accounting the nature's reaction to the positive change. So this is how we can see the positive change in the nature. Okay, just after the winter season, spring season is there. Okay, after the seasons, rain, winter, rainy season, winter season, okay, all harsh seasons, there is the season of love, the season of beauty, and that is spring. As the spring season comes, there is happiness all around. The birds are happy, the sun is happy, grass is happy, stream is happy, cattle are happy, people are happy, just because the bad time has gone. Okay, so winter season is also representing the bad time, bad situation. So one more thing we can say related to this poem, that this poem is actually telling after the bad time, the difficulties, the hardship, one is actually enjoy the good time. Okay, so have faith in yourself, okay, and wait for the good time. It will definitely come, but the thing is, you just have to be a good patient, so that you will enjoy that. Whenever the good time will come, you will really enjoy that, as the plowboy enjoys. Okay, so that's all about this poem. So once again, I just want to tell you the rhyming scheme. So these four lines is having rhyming scheme AABB. All right, these six lines are having rhyming scheme ABBCCA. Okay, now next four lines, we can say stanza number two, next four lines we are having here rhyming scheme AABB. Okay, next six lines rhyming scheme is ABBCCA. Got it? So this poem is written by William Wordsworth. All right. So this you should know. You should know the name of the poem and the name of the poet. Okay. Now glossary is given here. Words meaning are given here. You just have to write these words meaning from here in your notebook and you have to learn. Okay. Now I want everyone, every student to write the summary of this poem and send to me. Okay. Till the time, go through this video, watch it again and again and write the summary. Okay. Now thank you so much for watching. Just take care of yourself. Thank you.